We've got a really great morning this morning. We're going to see some breakthrough in our nation today, hey? We're going to start off with some worship, so please join us as we sing.
Let's sing that again. Let's sing that again. Heal my heart.
Heal my heart and make it clean. And open up my eyes to the things unseen. And show me how to love like you.
Yes, God, we step into your presence today, Lord, and we just thank you, Father, for this time that we can come together, that we can lift up, as your word says, lift up holy hands. And Lord, as we lift up our hands and our hearts to you, Lord, that you are made welcome, that you are pleased in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for today, and we thank you for this time together in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And we all said... And we all said, amen, amen, and amen. Just grab a seat if you can for just one quick moment. We're going to have a very different service here today, and I'm really excited about it, to be honest. I'm just going to explain a couple of things. We're going to, in a short few moments, we're going to take up our tithe and our offering. We're going to have communion later on in the service. And we're going to look at some of the key important dates that we've got coming up as well. But today I just sense the Holy Spirit just lay upon my heart during this week that today as a church, we're going to move into a time of prayer, worship, and breakthrough on behalf of our nation. And so, you know, we could normally just go through the motion and just go through a normal service, and we can have a four-song sandwich with a slice of turkey in the, or ham or and a bit of the word at the end and a little bit of prayer time, and we can all go about our merry day. Or we can come into a moment and into a place of purposeful prayer, worship, and intercession. And so I'm going to talk a little bit more about that a little bit later on. But the very first thing I just want to highlight to you is the three events that we've got coming up that are going to be pretty good, and you're going to definitely need to take notice of the first one, which is Church in the Park, which is next Sunday. So we're going to take church out into the park. And what does that mean? That means spending time together, having time of, getting to know each other in an informal setting. And we're going to hopefully snag some barbecues and throw some snags on the barbecues. Is that cool? So it is BYO everything. So we're going to do our best to get a park bench and a seat. It's like people lie in wait to get those park benches, let me tell you, under the cover. Has anybody had to get early to a park to try and snag the barbecue and the park bench and the park table? It's like vicious, it's ferocious. And if you're the first one, people turn up in the car park and they spy out which one's available. And then as they walk past, you can just sit back and, yeah, I was here before you. So it's just going to be great fun. There is no service here next week. There's no service here. Am I making that clear, Sam? So you can come here and you can have a great time in the car park, but you won't be able to get in. So that's Church in the Park. We have a special Australia Day lunch on the 26th of January here. So don't eat breakfast that morning. Come and have a great a sausage sizzle straight after church on Sunday on January 26th, where we really get to celebrate Australia. You know, sometimes in Australia, we're not that patriotic, or we're not verbally patriotic. But I tell you what, when we come under fire, then we get our feathers ruffled a bit, don't we? Amen? So let's just celebrate Australia on the 26th and by having lunch together again there. Identity Conference. Who's ready for Identity Conference? I'll talk to these guys because these guys are ready. Who's ready for Identity Conference? Fantastic. Identity Conference for 2020. This is 20. We're in 2020. Can you believe it? Like, I've been talking about, 2020 that's over there somewhere, but it's actually here right now. So March 13 and 14 is our Identity Conference. The theme is all about, yes, developing who you are in Christ and who Jesus says that you are, but more importantly, what it is to walk with Him, walking with Jesus, walking with Him in a new way, in an intimate way. And we've just started to imagine that it'd be like, going back to the Garden of Eden and the purposes of that Jesus was in beautiful relationship with Adam and Eve. And that is our opportunity today. Amen. So that's what Identity Conference is going to be all about. Mark that in your diary, March 13 and 14. And I believe that you can book tickets online through the manninghamcc.org website, which is fantastic. And so for all you tech-savvy people, jump on the website. You can book tickets through that, and we will take care of you that way. Fantastic. All right. We're going to take up our tithe and our offering, and just ask that you prepare yourself for that. On your chair, there will be the tithe and offering envelopes. And, I'm not going to talk too much about this right now. I would imagine that there's going to be opportunity equally that as a church in the coming weeks, we're going to be able to identify some key charities or relief that we can sow into and give into in the coming in the coming weeks. I'm not sure whether there's particularly a bushfire up here or anything like that at the moment, but we're gonna see what we can do as a church. But more importantly, today we're going to see what we can do as a church spiritually, and that is first and foremost as well. And so as we give, the Lord says, give, bring your tithe into the storehouse and see and test me that I will not open up the windows of heaven to pour out a blessing that you cannot contain. Well, right now, I would encourage maybe even, you know, it's just upon my heart even now that we would give, that the rains would open up and pour out a blessing like that on this nation. Amen. And so as we give and as we sow it as seed for multiplication, not only for us, but for this nation of Australia. Amen. Amen. So I'm going to pray and then I'm going to ask the Fit team to take that up. Jesus, right now, we just thank you for your love. We just thank you for your provision that you have so abundantly blessed us. You have so abundantly poured out into us. And Lord, we don't give out of what we have spare, but Lord, we give to you first. And Lord, we just thank you that as we sow and as we give this tithe, and we give our offering to you, Lord, right now, that you would be honored, that you would be blessed, and Lord, that it would be multiplied, good measured, pressed down, shaken together, and as your word says, running all over in Jesus' name. So, Lord, we just thank you, Father, for that right now. And we all said, amen and amen. Let's give. Thank you. So, as you're giving, I'm just going to share ever so briefly how today's going to work. Are you ready? Turn to the person beside you and say, are you ready? It's going to be good. Say, this is going to be good. Who gets excited about stepping into moments of prayer? Yeah. Prayer is just so evidently powerful. It's like, you know, sometimes it can be a labor. It's not a political joke. It's not. Just kidding. Sometimes it can be labor. Sometimes stepping into a time of prayer is a choice more than a feeling. Sometimes stepping into moments of prayer and sometimes stepping into moments of worship feels like a sacrifice. It feels like, you know what, I don't really feel like doing this right now, but I'm just going to be obedient. Sometimes it feels like, well, you know, I don't know how to do this right now, so I'm just going to trust the Holy Spirit is just going to lead me. Amen? And so I think most times we step into prayer, we step into that last place. Holy Spirit, I don't know what to say, I don't know what to do, but I'm just going to keep moving and step forward in faith that you're going to lead me. And that's certainly my prayer for you today. But in terms of prayer and spiritual development, I've just got some key thoughts and key ideas that I want to briefly share with you. We're not going to open up too much scripture right now because I want to keep you fresh for what we're actually going to do, all right? Turn to the person beside you and say, stay fresh. Do you need a Mentos? Fresh mint or, I don't know, drink Sprite or something like that. Okay, so prayer and spiritual development. The first point that I want to give to you, that if you're madly taking notes, the heart of an intercessor. So intercession is really stepping into that place of yes, prayer, but interceding and revealing the heart of man towards God. Now, how many know that God knows the heart of man already? Hello? But we get this opportunity and this privilege of presenting our hearts and presenting on behalf of even this nation, the heart of this nation towards God. How many know that right now this nation needs God? You know, Josh said to me just the other day, he said, Dad, he goes, why isn't God doing anything about these bushfires? And, you know, that's a really honest, straight question. It's a good question. And you know, as a parent, you go, well, God is, and, you know, we just may not see it yet. And, you know, there's those sorts of answers. But at the moment, there's this point of intercession and faith where we desperately cry out to God. We need a desperate move of God here. Politicians are politicking. You know, there's people flexing their muscles. There's people trying to take opportunity and news coverage and media coverage and all sorts of things that are going on. Well, forget all of that. We just need these fires to stop and this nation to bow its knees to Jesus. Yeah, hello? And so, the heart of the intercessor, it really, Moses is one that comes to mind. And in Exodus 32, chapter 32, verse 11 to 14, and verses 30 to 34, Moses demonstrates his unselfish, life-surrendering intercession that prevails beyond otherwise destructive effects of human weakness and sinning. You know, somebody once asked me, is this all about God's judgment? No. That's Old Testament theology. It's not God's judgment upon Australia. It's not because of this law or that legislation. I'll tell you right now that most of it is because of man has mismanaged. You see, we have been given an authority and we have been given a position here on this earth. Way back to the Garden of Eden, God said, have dominion. Have dominion. It means have authority. Take care of the garden. And take care of this earth. And so I'm not talking about climate change. I'm just simply talking about good management of the resources that we have. Amen? The second point and the second person that comes to mind in terms of prayer and spiritual development is Joshua. Joshua and his warriors, and they stood in the gap in Joshua chapter 10, verses 12 to 14. They stood in the gap contending for God's eternal purposes, teaching the triumph such faith may realize in spiritual warfare. You remember the walking around Jericho? Remember the story? And Joshua was told by the Lord to walk around Jericho. And one of the very specific instructions, you know, can you imagine if they woke up one day and just said, well, no, I don't feel like marching around this city. I don't feel like it. It's raining. Can you imagine it? All right? No, they knew what they were called to do. God had said, I'm going to give Jericho into your hands. And so at that point, Joshua gave these very clear instructions. He called for absolute silence across the nation. It's a very interesting point that he did. He called for no one to speak. Why did he do that? Well, I predict that why he did that, my assumption, is that he did that so that there would not be any faithless negative talk. And I'm not just talking about negativity. I'm talking about language that would destroy what God's intent and what God's plan was. Hello? Because how many know and have read the Old Testament that the Israelites tended to be a bunch of whingers? Oh, we haven't got any meat, but you've got this perfect heaven's food manna. Oh, but we haven't got any water. Oh, well, let's split this rock open and just water you all. Hello? What about you? I haven't got any money in the bank. You know, I tend to whinge. Do you tend to whinge a bit too? No, of course not. No, the point is here is that... In that place of intercession is not a whinge. Intercession is saying, God, we need you. We need you to move. We need you to stretch out your strong and mighty hand. We need you here. God, this, I know that you know it's really bad, but I'm just reminding you that I can see too that it's really bad. Hello? All right. Isaiah. Third thing, Isaiah 36, chapter 1, sorry, Isaiah chapter 36, verses 1 to 37, is where Hezekiah and Isaiah demonstrate the power of prayer to face troublesome times and break evil powers. In this story, Israel was surrounded by Assyria. Surrounded. And at that point, Israel was just a small little nation. They had been absolutely ransacked. They'd lost all the gold. Hezekiah had already paid all the gold out of the temple. And that night, the angel of the Lord killed over 185,000 people of the enemy. And there was a great slaughter. Now, I mean, I know that's really might be an ugly thing to talk about here in church today. But the truth is this, is God is for his people. God is for when we pray. He answers. He steps in. He steps up. When we pray, he steps in. Amen? All right. We only have to look at Acts chapter 13, where 13 and 14, where prayer and fasting birthed signs and wonders. Are you ready to see some amazing signs and wonders? I was looking at the map over Australia and I could start to see some rain clouds developing. And I'm speaking into those rain clouds saying, you will contain water. You will pour out a beautiful and drenching rain in the dry places. There will be springs of living water welling up in the paddocks, in the trees. Amen? Putting the fires out. Amen? So prayer and fasting, God may call you to a time of fasting, fasting from something. Amen? Acts chapter 4, prayer is often the proving grounds of our faith. Hello? You know, you can't have faith if you don't pray, and you don't pray if you don't have faith. Even the faith the size of a mustard seed. Well, that's only little, isn't it? And you might say those words, well, if faith moves mountains, this is all I've got. And guess what? God says his grace is always sufficient, so it's always going to be enough. Amen? Amen? Unceasing prayer is a key to deliverance. This nation needs to be set free, needs to be delivered from this situation. And unceasing prayer. So I would encourage you, pray this morning, but continue to pray this afternoon. Continue to pray tomorrow. Amen? And the last thing I want to share is this, is that prayer is agreeing with God's will. Prayer is agreeing with God's will. None of what is happening right now has anything to do with God's will. People die every day, not according to God's will. Hello? All right? So sickness is not according to God's will. Hello? These fires are not according to God's will. So what we do in terms of prayer is we step into that place of we saying, okay, Lord, your will be done. The mandate of heaven through our life, we can release the power and anointing of God into these situations, even from this city of Manningham. Why? Because we're King's kids. We've been given an inheritance. Hello? King Jesus lives in here. And it's a good thing. Amen? So, let me explain to you how we're going to work the rest of the service today. So, our goal will finish up at around about 11:30. But we understand that as the Holy Spirit leads, and as we've already prayed during the prayer meeting this morning, that as the Holy Spirit leads, He ebbs and flows. In other words, He may lead us into a place of declaring love. He may lead us into a place of declaring truth. He may lead us into a place of coming against the plans of the enemy and breaking that. He may lead us into a place of where we're going to take communion a little bit later on, of where we're going to take communion not just on behalf of ourselves, but on behalf of this nation. You see, his blood was enough for our entire nation. Can a nation be saved in a day? Yes, absolutely it can. Absolutely. We saw in the story of David and Goliath, the nation was saved in one moment and in one day. So too, Australia can be saved. Amen? So, over on your left-hand side over here, you'll see a whiteboard, and you'll see pieces of paper with some key scriptures and some key concepts. Now, what may tend to happen during the next hour is your mind might start to wander on the fact that you might need another coffee or that you forgot to turn the hot rollers off at home. Or some people say, what are they? you might have forgotten to turn the iron off at home, maybe. Or you meant to send this email, or what's happening this afternoon? What I would encourage you to do is stay focused right up until 11:30. Stay focused on what God is calling you to do. And these are some tools that are going to help you. So if during this time of worship and prayer and intercession, if during this time, wow, thank you, Alan, you're amazing, let there be light, and there was, during this time of prayer and intercession, God may highlight one of these things to you. You may not even know what Psalm 91 is, but God may highlight something to you in that. And what I would encourage you to do as a step of faith, get up out of your seat, come forward and take that. Take it back to your seat as an act of faith, that as you go through this time of prayer, intercession and worship, that you would read Romans 8. You might during worship read it out loud. There's power in reading scripture out loud. And so as you do that, you may go, yep, Romans 8 is my thing. Yep, I'm going to pray for Prime Minister Scott Morrison and all the cabinet leaders. And I'm going to pray for the leadership of this nation. I'm going to pray for truth, that the media portrays absolute truth, that the truth of this whole situation is only what is heard and not muddied up so that the enemy takes advantage of it. You might want to pray about breaking fear. Whatever that might be, come up, grab it, and take it back to your seat and begin to pray about it. Begin to, you might, I would encourage you not to stay in your seat. For me, if I sit down, I tend to nod off. But I will often pray standing up and walking around. If God has given you something that is not up there, there's some pieces of paper here that we're going to leave just here with some whiteboard markers, and I would encourage you, either write it on the piece of paper and hold on to that, or write it up here on the board. Because what I've instructed the worship team to do is to worship bouncing off what the Holy Spirit is doing in us as a church. While Sam and Anna are going to be leading in worship, what I want us to be doing is moving together in unity in this time of prayer and intercession. So if you perhaps write up here a scripture of Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Well, then the Holy Spirit may give Anna a song to start singing in response to what you have felt the Holy Spirit do here. Is that cool? Okay. Now, if for those who I have already prompted some people and asked some people that throughout this time to come up, read scripture into this microphone here, and also and pray, then I would encourage those people to do that throughout the service. But if you would like to, and this is open to everybody here, if you would like to come up and pray and read scripture and pray, then this mic is available to you. Now, it does come with a condition. We're not praying about John and Marge down the street, and we're not praying for your long-lost cousin. We're specifically praying and uplifting this nation of Australia with that responsibility. Is that cool? So I've given Len permission that if you start praying or preaching, he will press the sucks button. It'll go, no, no good, mute. Okay? Now, don't be offended by that, but the point is this, is that God has called us for a purpose this morning, and that is to uplift this nation in prayer. Is that cool? It's not about somebody else's agenda. It's about His for today. Is that all right? Fantastic. So, once again, here's the whiteboard markers. They all work. There's pieces of paper. As the worship team leads us, that's how we're going to press in. You ready? All right. Father, we just thank you for today. I just encourage you to stand up on your feet. Father, we just thank you for today. And Lord, we thank you for what you are doing in this place and in our hearts. Holy Spirit, we just commit today into your hands. Lord, we thank you for this time together. Lord, we thank you that you are walking with us and leading us and guiding us. Holy Spirit, we will follow you. So have your way in this house today, in Jesus' name.
We're going to sing "There's a River."
There's a river flowing from the mountain that shows our God is true. There's a song rising from the valley. It's our response to you.
Let's sing that again.
There's a river flowing from the mountains that shows our God is true. And there's a song rising from the valleys. It's our response to you.
I will sing of the goodness.
I just felt the Lord take me to the book of Joel. Yep. I just felt the Lord take me to the book of Joel. As our nation at the moment, there are many, many organisations seeking to work together and trying to work together, and they are actually starting to bump up against each other. So what the book of Joel says, I'm going to declare this as a prayer. And Joel 2:8 says this, and we just declare this over our nation. We declare it over every organisation, every government organisation, every other organisation that needs to come together. We thank you, Father, for this nation. We thank you for your protection over this nation. But this is the word of the Lord that we declare over this situation. They do not push one another. Everyone marches in his own column. Though they lunge between the weapons, they are not cut down. So, Lord, we thank you that the enemy would seek, Lord, to have organisations bump up against each other. He would seek to intervene. He would seek to interfere. And we just declare that they will not be cut down. They will walk between the weapons that the enemy has laid. And we thank you that they will march in their own column, Lord, and yet in unity it shall be done. Yet it shall be done. Thank you, Lord. We just declare, Lord, unity, Lord. We thank you for the coordination. We declare supernatural coordination, Lord, over this nation, because only you can do this, Lord. This is too big for us, but you can, Lord. So we thank you for your protection, Lord, and for your divine coordination over every agency, every person involved in this, that your will be done in Jesus' name.
Your goodness is running after me. Goodness, your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. Oh, we declare your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness, your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness, your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness.
Through the fire and in darkest night, you are close like no other, known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness. Come on, we'll sing it again. I love your voice. I've seen it happen. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night, you are close like mother. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend. You're so good. answer all our prayers, Lord. You're moving before we even ask, 'cause you're so good to me. Spirit of refreshing, sing a spirit of refreshing, falling down with blessings, spirit of refreshing. So in this time, I just encourage you to lift a melody. If you have something specific on your heart, God can hear everyone at once. It's the beauty of being God. So why don't you just open your mouth? If you're not sure what to sing, then just la la la.
Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain.
sings. Oh, Australia sings, yeah. Here the rain is falling down. Here the rain is falling down. Australia sings. Australia sings, yeah.
Let's just begin to thank God for healing, for people who have been impacted by this fire, both emotional healing and physical healing. And when fire goes through anything, everything that's dead before, after the fire has left, will be rebirth. There will be a rebirth in this nation, and God will cause a restoration. Everything that's died will come back again, in Jesus' name.
New life, new season, new wine. It's new life, new season, new wine. New life, new season, new wine. Drink it in, Lord. We drink it in. Sing a new life, new season.
Lola said in Isaiah 61, it says that he will give us beauty for ashes and the oil of gladness for mourning. And we pray that and declare that over the whole land of Australia.
Yes.
And for people that live outside of Australia that have relatives or friends or have connections to Australia, Lord, this is worldwide. This isn't just for Australia. And we just thank you, Lord, for what you will do with the healing in the hearts of the people.
Yes.
And bring them more to God. Bring them to your heart, that they will come down on their knees and they will ask for protection for their loved ones. And we thank you for that, Lord, in what you are doing worldwide.
Father, I thank you that we fear no evil. Father, that you, our Lord, are the one that brings peace. And even though I walk through the valley of this shadow of death, I will fear no evil. And I know, Father, that you're the God of peace. And so we break fear in Jesus' name over this nation. We break fear over this nation. We fear the Lord. We break fear. We break fear to set us free. We break fear to be coordinated. We break fear that we can see. We can break fear that we can see that you will not hold these people. You will not hold these children. You will not hold us any longer. We see the word of God. We see restoration.
Yes.
And we see peace.
Yes.
We speak shalom.
Yes.
Over this nation.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Yes. Breaking fear.
Yes.
This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Yes, Lord. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles.
This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Right here, God, now. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Yes, Lord. Oh, this is how I fight my battles. 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 Here may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Here may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Here may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Here may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you.
The Lord said in Isaiah 41, excuse me, verse 10, so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, and I will help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And I declare that into everybody's heart, that they will believe this, that they will believe the Lord, that he will do great things in this tragedy. You also say in Isaiah 54:17, no weapon forged against us will prevail.
That's right.
And you will not refute every single tongue that accuses you.
That's right.
That is the heritage of the servants of the Lord. And this is the vindication from me, declares the Lord.
Yes.
There is so much negative talk, and what has come out already, and we need to be silent and we need to be positive. And we pray that.
Yes.
We pray that the negative is gone and only positive and truth. And that the media will actually change its position. Even though it seems like that's impossible, the media will change its position to truth, and they will see the hand of God, and more will come out about it, the blessings that have been happening that have not been seen. And we thank you that all of things will work together for good.
Yes, God.
In Jesus' name, thank you.
Look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Stepping into battle like we've got this, 'cause he's given us the tools we need, yeah. Oh, we're stepping into battle 'cause we got this. He's given me everything I need. Oh, we're stepping into battle like we've got this, 'cause he's given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I've got this, 'cause he's given me everything I need, yeah. Oh, we're stepping into battle like we've got this, 'cause he's given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I've got this, 'cause he's given me everything I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle like I've got this, 'cause he's given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I've got this, 'cause he's given me everything I need, yeah. Oh, I'm stepping into battle like I've got this, 'cause he's given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I've got this, 'cause he's given me everything I need, yeah. Oh, you've given me all that. Yeah. Yeah.
to battle like I've got these, 'cause you've given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I got these. Oh, you've given me all I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I got these, 'cause you've given me the tools I need. Oh, I'm stepping into battle 'cause I have these. Oh, you've given me all I need. Yes, I have, Lord. Oh, we have all we need this morning. This is how I find my bags. This is how I find my bags. Oh, this is how I find my bags. This is how I find my battles. Wow. This is how I find my battles. This is how I fight my battles. Oh yeah. This is how I find my battles. This is how I find my battles. This is how I find my battles. Oh, I have all I need this morning. This is how I find my bags. This is how I find my bags. This is how I find my bags. Yes, Lord.
We know that praise is such a powerful weapon in battle. And Psalm 34 tells us this. And this is us. We will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in our mouths. Our souls shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with us as we exalt his name together. Lord, we just thank you that praise brings a breakthrough. Right now, we just declare, it's been written during the week, and I saw it in some of the news reports, that this nation is at a tipping point. So we declare right now that it will tip in favour of the will of the Lord. We just declare that this nation belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you that there is no other above his name in this nation. And we declare breakthrough right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare breakthrough in every area that's needed right now as his people. Doesn't matter how many there are, there is just enough people in this room. There are many of us in this room. That is enough. We are enough. Don't let the enemy tell us otherwise. We are enough. So we declare right now in the name of Jesus that this nation will turn towards the Lord Jesus Christ, that his will and his way, this nation belongs to the Lord. Enemy, you will not take it. You will not counterfeit. You will not undermine in the mighty name of Jesus. That, Lord, you reign. You will reign supreme. That your glory will be seen over this nation. Amen. Let's praise him.
As we continue to pray and just worship, we're going to have communion together. see, communion, the reason why Jesus shed his blood and gave of his life was to bring us into right relationship. And every single time there has been a blood covenant made throughout the history of man, it was always to establish relationship. And so right now we get to celebrate together right relationship with God. And so right now, Father, we just thank you and we declare over this nation that this nation would be in right relationship with you, Lord. Lord, we celebrate the very nature of the blood of Jesus. We celebrate right now the very nature of the covenant and the agreement that you have made, that you have instituted toward mankind. And so, Lord, we celebrate right now the very covenant and every single right and true prophetic word that you have spoken over this nation of Australia. Lord, we call this nation into a place of revival. Lord, we call this nation into a place of humility and honor, Lord. We call this nation into a place, Lord, where they are in right relationship with you, that we are in right relationship with you. And so, Jesus, right now, we celebrate the right covenant, the right relationship and total acceptance in you. And because of that right relationship, we break off every wrong relationship. Every work of the enemy, we place the blood of Jesus against it, and we command you to cease and desist. In fact, we turn your own sword against you. Where the fires and the flames of hell have tried to bring this nation to its knees, we now send it back to hell where it came from. And so right now in Jesus' name, we break the power of the enemy. We break the power of human effort. And Lord, we thank you for the absolute covenant. And Lord, that we can rest in the knowledge that you have completed the work. You have completed it. And so right now, the enemy must loose its hold in every single area of this nation in Jesus' name. Devil, get out of this country. Get out of this nation. Get out of our politics. Get out of our government. Get out of our hospitals. Get out of our schools. Get out of our communities right now in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you, Father, for it. We thank you, Father, for it. We thank you, Lord. And so right now, we're going to celebrate communion together. And Jesus took the blood, took the cup, and he said, this is the blood of the new covenant that is shed for the remission, the complete annihilation of sin. And so we get to celebrate that all sin has been washed away. All sin for those who would walk in right relationship with God, that all sin has been washed away. And then he took the bread and he said, this is my body broken for you. And the Bible says that he was the lamb slain before the foundation of the earth. He had already given up his life for us. He had already given up his life for us. And so right now we've got the FIT team down the front here and they're just going to hold communion there for you for the next few minutes. And when you feel led to do so, come down and take it. You can take it down the front here. You might feel the need to kneel down the front. You might feel the need to take it back to your chair and just spend that time with him. But I would welcome you to come down, help yourself as the FIT team, just stand here and just serve you. And come and take communion and remember its right relationship with God, that the blood has been shed, that his body has been broken for us. Thanks, guys.
As we humble ourselves and seek your face, fall on our knees and turn from our way as we humble ourselves and seek your face.
Romans 8 speaks of Jesus coming to be the fulfillment of what the law couldn't do and making a way for us back to Jesus. And it goes on to say that those who know him are led by his impulses. And then it speaks to the condition of the world. And as this word is spoken, it is the power of God that will open our eyes to see the world as it is, to see the world as what it wants and what it needs, and we will stop telling ourselves that the kingdom of God and the church is on the back foot because we are on the front foot. So in Romans 8, it says, I am convinced that any suffering we endure is less than nothing compared to the magnitude of glory that is about to be unveiled within us. The entire universe, our whole world, all of Australia, stands on tiptoes, yearning to see the unveiling of God's glorious sons and daughters. For against its will, the universe has had to endure the empty futility resulting from the consequence of sin. The world did not want to be separated from God. But now, with eager expectation, all creation longs for freedom from slavery to decay and to experience with us the wonderful freedom of coming to God's children. To this day, we are aware of the universal agony and groaning of creation as if it were the contractions of labor for birth. And it's not just creation. We who have already experienced the first fruits of the Spirit also inwardly groan as we passionately long to experience our full status of God as God, God's sons and daughters, including our physical bodies being transformed. Lord, release healing right now as your scripture and your powerful word enters our body and our souls and our spirits. For this is the hope of salvation. But hope means that we must trust and wait for what is still unseen, salvation for our families, healing for our land, and good character and all good things in our government. So because of hope is set on what is yet to be seen, we patiently keep waiting for its fulfillment. And in a similar way, the Holy Spirit takes hold of us in our human frailty to empower us in our weakness. For example, at times we don't even know how to pray or know the best thing to ask for, but the Holy Spirit rises up within us to super intercede on our behalf, pleading to God with emotional sighs too deep for words. God, the searcher of the heart, knows fully our longings, yet he also understands the desires of the Spirit because the Holy Spirit passionately pleads for God before God for us, his holy ones in perfect harmony with God's plan and our destiny. So we are convinced that every detail of our lives is continually woven together to fit into God's perfect plan of bringing good into our lives. For we are his lovers who have been created to fulfill his designed purpose. For he knew all about us before we were born, and he destined us from the beginning to share the likeness of his son. This means the son is the oldest among a vast family of brothers and sisters who will become just like him. Having determined our destiny ahead of time, he called us to himself and transferred his perfect righteousness to everyone he called. And those who possess his perfect righteousness, he co-glorified with his son. So what does all this mean? If God has determined to stand with us, tell me, who could stand against us? Who could ever separate us from the endless love of God's anointed one, Jesus? Absolutely no one. For nothing in the universe has the power to diminish his love toward us. Troubles, pressures, problems are unable to come between us and heaven's love. What about persecutions, deprivations, dangers like fires, and death threats? No. For they are impotent to hinder an omnipotent love. So now I live with the confidence that there is nothing in the universe with the power to separate us, me, from the love of God. Nothing in this universe can separate my brother, my friends, from the love of God. I am convinced that his love will triumph over death, over life's troubles, over fallen angels or dark rulers in the heavens. There is nothing in our present or future circumstance that can weaken his love. There is no power above us or beneath us, no power that could ever be found in the universe that can distance us from God's passionate love, which is lavished upon us through Lord Jesus, the Anointed One. We walk into 2020 with our eyes open to a world that is groaning for Jesus. Holy Spirit, we leave this building and into our day, our workplace, our school, our families, wherever we travel, we walk through a groaning world for your love and restoration. We are aware of you, Holy Spirit, and we invite you to lead us. We invite you to lead us to reach those closest to us, to know that every person we lay our eyes on, you have something to say to them. And this week I was reminded of, of the story in the Old Testament where they were building in 2 Kings and they were using an axe, and as they were using it, the head of the axe fell into the river and they said, oh God, what do we do now? That was borrowed. We need that to do our job. And they come up and he says, where did it fall? And he said, there. And he threw the stick in the water and the axe head rose to the surface of the water. This is the year where things that were impossibly lost return to the kingdom of God. This is the year where family members who are in impossible situations come to know that nothing can separate them from the love of God. This is the year where finances that seem impossible are met. Financial needs are met. This is the year where healing that is impossible medically, we stand in a full restorated body. This is the year where this church walks into our community with the boldness of understanding that the last few years have been a hard slog and it's kind of been a little bit impossible to take ground, but this is the year where we walk knowing that we have this because God has this. And we just with boldness invite people to church. We just with boldness say, God told me to tell you this. We with boldness tell people what he's done in our lives. Because what can separate us from the love of God? Absolutely nothing. Thank you, Jesus.
Stand with us. You shall return in robes of white.
Thank you, Father. Lord, we just give you praise. We give you all glory and all honor, Lord, right now. We just thank you for breakthrough. We thank you for this moment of breakthrough, oh Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that you are the God of the turnaround, Lord. And so, Lord, we thank you right now for your presence, Lord. We exalt you and we praise you and we lift you up above all things. Lord, today we declare that there is no other name higher than the name of Jesus. There is no other name higher than the one who came and died for the world, was risen again, and now sits at the right hand of the Father. And so, Lord, we thank you for your lordship, and we thank you that you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords, in Jesus' name. And we all said, amen and amen. Hey, fantastic. What a great time of prayer and breakthrough and intercession. I just want to thank you for being here today and for absolutely committing to this time together. I'm just absolutely looking forward to hearing the news reports throughout the day and throughout the coming days. And not just the stories of courage, but the stories, not just the stories of courage and heroism, but right now the stories of if it had not been for the Lord. Amen? Amen? Amen. Well, look, grab a coffee. You're welcome to stay. And as we go about this day, continue to pray, continue to incline your ear to the Lord so that he will speak into your life and bless you indeed. Amen? Amen. God bless you. We'll see you next week at the park. God bless.